President Marcos now back in Manila following what he calls a short but highly productive visit to the United Arab Emirates. He arrived home at around 10 this morning. During his one-day trip, the president was able to boost Manila's ties with the Gulf state in the fields of energy, artificial intelligence, digital economy, among others. Marcos also invited UAE President Sheikh Al Nahyan to the Philippines to explore more areas of cooperation.
At this brief visit, I reaffirm the Philippines' commitment to further strengthen our bilateral ties, progressing towards new spheres of engagement. I look forward to the implementation of several bilateral agreements in culture, energy transition, legal cooperation, artificial intelligence, a digital economy, the improvement of government activities, visa waiver for holders of diplomatic, special, and official passports, and investment cooperation.
Government's macroeconomic targets might be revised in the next meeting of the Development Budget Coordination Committee following domestic and global developments. Meanwhile, the Asian Development Bank sees the Philippines' robust growth ideal for Islamic finance. Lady Vicentia tells us more.
Budget Secretary Amena Pangandaman sees a possible revision of the Philippines' economic growth and fiscal targets in the Development Budget Coordination Committee's meeting in December. The budget chief said revisions are likely, given the possible impact of the peso's depreciation against the dollar and the re-election of Donald Trump.
Based on the numbers, the agencies are utilizing their budget now. All the programs and projects of infrastructure and social, lahat umaandar sabay-sabay. So you know that that will contribute a lot also to our growth.
Domestically, Pangandaman said the economic team remains focused on hitting the targets despite the ongoing clash between the two highest government officials.
At least for the economic team, di ba, ano kami, tuloy-tuloy lang kami, di ba, assistance ko, we're still on track. In fact, we just signed the Create More. So the agencies in charge are working on, drafting the IRR. And then next year, we are scheduled to go abroad again for the economic briefings.
The Philippines' economic growth slowed to 5.2% in the third quarter, bringing average GDP for the first three quarters of 2024 to 5.8%. But Pangandaman still sees the Philippines hitting the full-year target of 6-7%. For the Asian Development Bank, the country's robust growth is ideal for Islamic finance. A study by the ADB showed opportunities with interest in Islamic financial products reaching 78%. It also wants to see more Muslim Filipinos with bank accounts, which now stands at 38%, significantly lower than the national average of 56% Filipinos in the formal banking system.
One of the most transformative impacts of Islamic finance is the potential to increase financial inclusions. And that was something that we were looking at right at the beginning when we started this, and particularly in regions such as the Muslim Bank Smaller region of Muslim Mindanao.
The Banco Central ng Pilipinas also sees Islamic finance as a very promising sector to drive financial inclusion and sustainable economic growth.
A recent market study underscores the sector's vast untapped potential, particularly among underserved Muslim communities seeking Sharia-compliant financial services. Our vision goes beyond inclusion. We see Islamic finance as a driver of sustainable economic growth.
The central bank reports several institutions have expressed interest to enter the Islamic banking market as demand increases. Two potential foreign players are eyeing to invest in Islamic banking in the Philippines.
There are a number of banks and non-banks which signify interest, but I cannot disclose yet because they have not really submitted a formal application. No? But there are a number of interested potential investors.
The BSP is currently regulating two Islamic banking windows and one Islamic bank. Lady Vicentia, ABS-CBN News.